Hi, I'm Bob Laliberte, Principal Analyst with theCUBE Research, and I'm very excited to be here with Shailesh Manjrekar, the Chief AI and Marketing Officer at Fabrix.ai. Welcome, Shailesh.
Hey, thank you, Bob, and welcome everyone. Super excited to be hosting this show, co-hosting this show along with SiliconANGLE and ZK Research.
Yeah, absolutely. Today's program is all about that next phase of AI, moving beyond experimentation and into agentic AI operations, where intelligent agents don't just make the recommendations, they're taking action across enterprise systems. So over the next few hours, we're bringing together analysts, customers, and partners to explore how organizations can operationalize agentic AI responsibly, efficiently, and at scale. Now, Shailesh, Fabrix.ai has been gaining a lot of momentum in the market, and this event feels like a major milestone. What inspired you and the team to host this half-day event now?
Yeah, no, absolutely, Bob. We are really at an inflection point with agentic, right? And every enterprise, small or large, wants to be an autonomous enterprise, right? Yeah. However, what we are seeing is there is what I call as AI value gap, right? So there are a lot of these AI projects happening, but really how much do they contribute to actually an outcome is where enterprises are struggling with. So today, we are kind of debunk that, right? And I primarily have these 3 points which we'll be focusing on throughout this presentation, right? First and foremost, what is kind of holding back the enterprises is the organizational kind of change management, right? Or the organizational awareness. And what I mean by that is when you onboard a digital workforce, how does an existing workforce interact with them, right? How do you kind of, leverage them? So that's kind of the first point what we'll be talking about. Right. The second point we'll be talking about throughout this presentation is really about what I call AI debt, right? And when I talk about AI debt, it can be technology, it could be your data, or it could be your, governance models, right? Yeah. So that's kind of the second point. And the third point is, hey, all of this is good, but how do you actually operationalize agentic, right? And that's where our AgentOps frameworks comes into picture and so on and so forth. So those are the three key themes we'll be focusing throughout this presentation as we go along, Bob.
Yeah, I think that's great. I mean, it's really such an important conversation that we have to have because AI just, it really can't be a lab experiment anymore. It needs to deliver value at scale safely and intelligently. So I know that one of the speakers at a conference I was recently at made the comment that there'll be no fast followers in AI. So it really underscores that importance of getting things started and getting it operationalized. Now, I know there's a lot of organizations that may be joining us who may not be familiar with Fabrix.ai. So I'm hoping, Shailesh, you could provide us with maybe a quick overview of who Fabrix.ai is, what makes your approach to AI operations unique and how you fit into the market overall.
Yeah, no, absolutely. So Fabrix.ai is essentially, we are the inventor of the data fabric to begin with, and now the agentic operational intelligence platform. And what I mean by that is think of us as the connective fabric, right? So we are a leading agentic AI operational intelligence platform and with 3 distinct value propositions. So first and foremost, what I call is we are a full stack agentic operational platform, right? That means we bring together the perception, the cognition and action using our data fabric, our AI fabric and our automation fabric. The second is about we are a purpose-built platform because when it comes to IT operations, as you probably know, we are really dealing with something very different than in the business intelligence world, right? Here we are dealing with real-time data, we are dealing with alerts, we are dealing with time series data and so on and so forth. So you need a purpose-built platform which can handle this real-time context, right? So that's the second kind of value proposition which is distinct about the platform. And the third is we are enterprise grade, right? So as I keep saying, LLMs is a means to an end. There have to be several building blocks around LLMs which actually makes it enterprise ready, right? And we'll be dwelling about it throughout our presentation today and kind of hopefully towards the end of the segment, the audience will walk away with the enterprise capabilities, what we have in terms of guardrails, in terms of dynamic MCP server, and so on and so forth.
Excellent. No, that's great. And I really like that term, connective fabric. It's a good metaphor for what Fabrix AI is enabling, not just AI in isolation, but AI that's embedded into the operational DNA of an organization. Let's take a look at what's coming up next in today's event. We've got a fast-paced, content-rich agenda that really spans the entire journey from the market trends all the way to real-world outcomes. Right after this, we're going to begin with our market trends and research session, and Zias Carafala, Dave Valente, and I will join Shailesh and Fabrix AI CTO Raju Penzmetsa to explore the current state of enterprise AI, including recent studies that have garnered significant attention lately. Let's just say we'll be taking a closer look at what's really happening in the market.
Yeah, no, absolutely, Bob, and we are thrilled to put this agenda together. After this session, we'll be talking about the AgentOps Foundation, which brings together automation and observability. We'll be talking about how AI agents coordinate our three fabrics and they work in unison.
Yeah, right, and then after that, we're gonna move into agentic use cases showing how this technology comes to life in the real world.
Absolutely, and after that, we'll be talking about how we are actually helping customers in real life reduce their operational costs, accelerate innovation, and embrace this agentic era.
Right, and then we're gonna actually directly hear from customers about the business impact that they're getting and how they're quantifying ROI from their AI initiatives.
Yeah, Bob, and finally, we'll be talking to our partners who are the real enablers for us, right? The big guys are like Cisco and IBM. So stay towards the end, all the way to the end, to kind of really enjoy this whole session.
Yeah, I think there's gonna be a lot of value for organizations who are watching this. There's a great mix of demos, analyst perspective, and customer stories, which makes it highly actionable. And Shailesh, one thing I appreciate about this agenda is that it's not just about technology, but there's a focus on outcomes. So many times the focus is just technology based, and so getting that outcome based is going to be really important. So with that said, what do you hope attendees will take away from today?
Yeah, no, absolutely. This event is about empowerment, right? So we want the attendees to walk away not just being kind of knowledgeable about agentic, but really about how do you operationalize this, right? You'll see practical frameworks, you'll see real customer examples, right, which demonstrates value. As we'll be talking more about in the session as well, we have launched this AAA program, which stands for Agentic AI Acceleration, which kind of takes away a lot of these pain points from customers, right, and makes it easy for them to kind of embark on this autonomous journey. Right, and again, I'll be dwelling a lot more on how this kind of all comes to fusion, right? And as you can imagine, from a product market fit as well, this is a very transformational time what we are staying at, right? And the market is so huge, it's really turning things on its head. If you look at the IT ops market in particular, it's estimated to be almost a $100 billion market, up from $36 billion where it was for observability and AI ops, right? Yeah. And the reason for this is we are not just looking at product-centric approach, but we are looking at workforce-centric approach, right? And what I mean by that is kind of consider the agentic world as you were dealing with BPOs, right? Business process operators, right? That, hey, I am adding 5 SREs to my workforce. I am adding 5 IT ops to my workforce. So anybody from a persona perspective, IT ops, NOC ops, SEC ops, personas would find this really enlightening from a technology perspective and from a business perspective.
Yeah, no, I think that's great. And this is really about, how do you take AI from concept to a proven capability and ultimately to a competitive advantage for your organization. Coming up next, we'll be joined by Zias Carafala from ZK Research and Dave Valente from theCUBE and Raju Penmeta, CTO at Fabrix AI, to dig into the latest market trends and research shaping the AI landscape. So stay tuned, the conversation starts now.